Dan's a disaster. Oh, yes, Natasha Stanishevsky will join us on this edition of Jay and Dan to whip up some Grey Cup treats.
Okay. I don't know what you were doing during the day Wednesday, but if you didn't hear the news regarding the Toronto Maple Leafs, hang on to something. Maybe someone could be tuning
in. It's possible.
Yes.
Yeah, we appreciate the people who just wait for us to break the news to them.
Mike Babcock, fired, out. No longer head coach of the Leafs.
It was Brendan Shanahan who hired Mike Babcock 4 years and 6 months ago. And so the Maple Leafs president felt it was important that he fly into Arizona to deliver Wednesday's news in person. Meanwhile, general manager Kyle Dubas addressed the situation with the players and staff. Shanahan alone took questions from the media.
We're mistake prone on defense. The attention to details aren't there. And even the offense that our team, the explosive offense our team was known for, has been missing for a while now. So there's a lot of work for Sheldon to do, and there's a lot of work for the players to do. When you think that you know what the right decision is, you have to act on it. And I think that waiting at this point would have just been the wrong thing. We made a change today, but I think that Mike and Kyle have had a good working relationship. I know that there were changes made in the offseason and changes made to the coaching staff. And the commitment that management had and the coaching staff had to starting the season and having success was 100% pure and honest, and it just didn't work out that way.
Shanahan says Keefe, who's guided the Marlies since 2015 and won a Calder Cup in 2018, has earned this opportunity. He's already worked with 12 of the current Leafs, helping develop many of them. He's also worked extensively with Dubas, who hired him to run the Marlies bench and also hired him to be his coach in Sault Ste. Marie of the OHL. Mark Masters, TSN, Scottsdale, Arizona.
All right, so Sheldon Keefe, your new head coach of the Toronto Maple Leafs. As for Babcock, he said, quote, "I'm disappointed. We didn't have the start to the year we wanted, and that's on me. I want to thank the fans, media. I want to thank the city. It's spectacular. I loved every second of it. Wish the new group nothing but success. Morgan Riley's been here the whole time. Can't thank him enough. And all the players have got an opportunity to coach. It's been fantastic, and I wish them nothing but success."
Let's go buy the numbers. Babs. $50 million. On May 20th, 2015, Babcock became the 30th head coach in Leafs history, agreeing to an 8-year, $50 million contract, the richest contract ever given to a head coach.
If you think there's no pain coming, there's pain coming. I'm proud to be here today, and I look forward to the process, the battle, the pain, the fun, the journey.
He still terrifies me. The 2017-2018 season was Babcock's best in Toronto. The Leafs won 49 games, the most in franchise history. Picked up 105 points, the best total in team history. In parts of five seasons, Babcock's Leafs record, 173, 133, and 45. In the playoffs, the Leafs under Babcock went 8-12 and were 0-3 in games in which they could have clinched a playoff series. Babcock's teams have struggled this season, currently on a 6-game losing streak, with a 9-10-4 record at the time of his dismissal. Okay, so he's got 3 years remaining on an 8-year contract. He initially signed with the team back in 2015. If you're a Leaf fan saying, oh, we're still paying him, it's not your money. Don't worry about it. Made the playoffs in each of the last three seasons, but posted a record of just 8-12, as I said, and were eliminated in the first round each time. Joining us now from Dallas is TSN hockey analyst Ray Ferraro. Ray, you were in Vegas for Mike Babcock's final game as Leafs head coach. In the end, was it Babcock's stubbornness that cost him the job?
Well, I would say the record cost him a job at the end of the day. Mike is very resolute in how he thinks a team should be coached, a team should be run, the usage of the players. He was not very flexible, but that's part of what I think is a strength of Babcock. To me, guys, I think the biggest problem became the roster that was assembled and the roster that Mike Babcock probably would have preferred were two different things.
Ray, I feel like I know the answer to this, and it's Jason Spezza. Which player will benefit the most from this coaching change?
Well, I'm not so sure it would be Spezza, although, you know, he certainly didn't have a clean runway for sure. I mean, it started right before the first preseason game in St. John's, and it was clear there was going to be, you know, some friction at the very least over Spezza's playing time. But I look at a player like Tyson Berry, who's had a debacle of a first quarter of a season. Maybe Sheldon Keefe uses him in a different role. Maybe he gets a little more power play time. Maybe his partner changes. Maybe he feels a little more freed up by it. I mean, this is not the player that Toronto acquired. I mean, I've seen Tyson for a long time, and I think it'll be a benefit to him. Now, also, maybe Travis Dermott is going to, his role will expand. You know, he certainly knows Keith from the American League. But it's tough to say, because you might have in your head, or I might have in my head, who you think Keith will like or not like as a coach, like which players he's going to lean on. And it might be something totally different in his head. The first few games will tell quite a tale for what he initially feels about this team.
Thanks, Ray. Appreciate it.
You bet.
It's funny because when it comes to the Ontario NHL teams, wasn't it the Sens that were supposed to be the tire fire this season? Ottawa is still very much a work in progress, but the message from former Mike Babcock assistant DJ Smith seems to be getting through. 5 wins in their last 7 games, going into Montreal last night where Guy Carboneau was honored. Became the 67th Montreal Canadian to enter the Hall of Fame on Monday.
The 67th?
67th Montreal Canadian. Isn't that incredible? And he looks fantastic, too. Habs nearly convert here. Sends on an early 4-minute power play. Look at that. Jeff Petrie's shot sneaks through. Craig Anderson keeps it out. Midway through the frame, Cale Fleury. Big hit on Vladislav Namestnikov. And Namestnikov, as you can see, was away from the boards and in serious discomfort when he hit the ice. Left the game with a lower body injury. Did not return to the hockey game. Still no score. Or Dan hates when I say that. There is a score. It's 0-0. Early second, Nick Suzuki. 3 goals in his last 4 games. Now it's 1-0 Montreal. Midway through the second, J.G. Pageau. I mean, this guy. It's in the Tyler Ennis shot for his 10th goal this month. That leads the NHL for the month of November. Ahead of Connor McDavid and Patty Kane. Pretty big stars. It's pretty impressive. Pageau. Last bit into the frame, Mark Borowiecki to Ennis with the lob pass. Carey Price stands tall, playing back-to-back nights. I believe it was the first time this season Price has played back-to-back nights. It's tied through 40. No scoring in the third overtime. Brendan Gallagher, give and go with Philip Deneau. Can't beat Anderson. Anderson made 35 saves in this game. 14 seconds after that, Brady Tkachuk, who scored the game winner Tuesday in Detroit, sent in all alone and beats Carey Price. Ottawa, 1-6-1 in its first 8 games, 6-2 in their last 8 games. Montreal has lost 3 straight.
The Leafs are on the road, so when the Babs bomb dropped, Scotiabank Center's other tenants were home, the Raptors, a team whose coach has about an 8-mile leash to work with, considering Nick Nurse won a title his first year, and so far this season, undefeated at home. Taking on the Magic, OG Anunoby started with goggles on, took them off after a few minutes, keeps getting poked in the eye. Toronto's recent injuries allowed the bench to flourish. Second quarter, Chris Boucher blocks Rondé Hollis-Jefferson the other way. Now he misses, but Boucher, wee wee, quick back dunk by the Montreal native. Boucher takes the feed, throws down. Boucher, 14 points, 11 boards. Hollis-Jefferson takes the ball away from DJ Augustine. And the finish, that's nice. I give it a 7. Terrence Davis, how about him? Boucher finds the undrafted rookie in the corner for 3. Davis had a career-high 19 points. Fred Van Vliet, also undrafted, could be a candidate for most improved player. Van Vliet gets a high floater to fall in the third. How about a nice hesitation move? Another deuce wraps up 11 after 3.
good.
This one was never really in doubt. Van Vliet strips the ball, does the rest. He's averaging almost two steals a game.
Fred with the layup.
Van Vliet leads Hollis Jefferson to the rim. Add the foul. 24 points, 7 assists for Van Vliet. The Raptors 6-0 at home as they pick up win number 10.
You're watching Jay and Dan, Canada's number one television program. Alex Ovechkin, 15 goals so far this year, third in the NHL, coming in against the Rangers. First period, sends a puck around the boards, hits referee Furman South in the face.
Oh.
He was bleeding, he was down, he stayed in the game. Furman South from just outside of Pittsburgh, tough ref. Later, Ovi, great opportunity to score. Wide open cage, look at that! Missed the tap in for goal number 16, but I love now how Ovi has laughs with the goaltenders. Artemi Panarin, he's the bread man. 11 game point streak coming in. Snipe. 10 goals on the season, beats Braden Holtby. Fitting in pretty nicely with the blue shirts, third period. Bread man again. Caps it off with the high kick Selly. Let's see it again, the high kick Selly. Okay, that's what the bread man does now. Henrik Lundqvist ties Curtis Joseph for fifth most win in NHL history.
They were definitely talking about this at the drive-thru. Mike Babcock, fired, Leafs head coach. Here's your double-double, you're Babcock. Sheldon Keefe, named as his replacement, becomes the 31st head coach in Leafs franchise history. Here's your donut. What about Babs? Sens beat the Canadians 2-1 in overtime. Brady Tkachuk with the winner.
Here's your hot soup. Oh, I spilled it. Oh, no.
You hearing
about Babs?
Run your club.
Raptors beat the Magic 113-97. Fred Van Vliet led all scorers with 24.7 assists. Toronto perfect 6-0 at home this year.
You ever get a hot soup at a drive-thru, Toolsy?
Ah, you're playing with fire.
Yeah, you are. There's Luka Doncic. What a stud. Coming off an historic 42-point triple-double. Casually drills the three from the logo by the seat of his pants. Warriors, Mavs. Warriors, not good. They have nobody. Luka was just getting started. His name is Luka. He goes inside the paint with the slam. He'll scoop up the loose ball. And then he'll dish a dime to Dorian Finney-Smith. If you hear baskets in the game, that means Luka Doncic hit a three. That's his fifth three of the quarter. In the second quarter, he continued. He'll knock down a step back three. Apologies to Suzanne Vega. Luka Doncic finished the first half with 33 points. Most in a half by any player this season. Only missed one field goal. Third quarter, defenders all over Luka. Finds Kristaps Porzingis.
Who is on Golden State?
Now, there's no one there. Nobody. Look at that score. It's a disaster.
I think I saw someone from our staff on that team. Nick Sixers. Ben Simmons, 0 for 17 from beyond the arc in his career. Yet to attempt a three this season. Guess what he did first quarter? Simmons' first ever three. They gave him a lengthy standing ovation. The Twitter account tracking if Ben Simmons has made a three. It's over, done, hang the banner.
That's awesome. Nice form, too.
Yeah, fourth quarter. Simmons through the lane. Drops two of his 18. He had a double-double with 13 assists under minutes ago. Joel Embiid. Yeah, he knows how to hit threes. He's shooting just under 40% this season from beyond the arc. Sixers, hey, guess what? They're a perfect 5-0 at home.
Mm. A collision course with the Rappy Raps.
We had so much Babcock news, we're doing a later walkover than usual.
Yeah, we don't have time for a lot of chit-chat.
No.
Okay. All right, in the very first drive of the CFL season, Dan, Hamilton Simone Lawrence laid a hit on now Blue Bombers quarterback Zach Collaros that knocked him out for almost the entire CFL season. Well, Sunday, Lawrence tweeted out his congratulations to Zach Collaros, his opposing quarterback in the Grey Cup.
Because I think what Zach Caleros did was pretty amazing, you know, to be out the whole season and then go and play a competitive Calgary team in, like, Calgary. That's, like, that's a tough thing to do. And then go play Saskatchewan and then win that. He played very well. So I was just proud of him, you know. Whatever happened earlier in the season, you know, happened. And, you know, I'm still my dude. Like, I still like him, still care for him. So I was just proud of him. I'm not a polite person, you know, playing football, you know. It's the only time I get to be mean. I'm nice to everybody, you know. But football, I get to be mean, so I take advantage of it.
Yeah, I don't really use social media that often, so kind of is what it is. The trash talk thing is kind of a media-driven thing, so.
It started off so well, and then Zach kind of brought it down.
Ahead of the 107th Grey Cup on Sunday, the CFL on TSN panel was properly welcomed to Calgary on Wednesday.
Gentlemen, I want to welcome you all to Calgary. My name is Cindy Good. I'm from Tourism Calgary, and I am here to bring you that gift from Calgary that we are so thrilled to share with visitors. It is called the official white hat. Biggest Yahoo you can. One, two, three, Yahoo! Gentlemen, you are all now honorary Calgarians.
It's the 107th Grey Cup from Calgary Tabbies Bombers. It's a Canadian tradition.
Garnet Hathaway has been suspended 3 games without pay by the National Hockey League for spitting in the face of Eric Goodbranson during a brawl Monday. The Caps forward has 2 goals, 7 points in 23 games this season. Hathaway released the following statement. In my view, it was a hectic situation coming out of a fight. There was a second, third, and fourth man that came in, and I got sucker punched a few times, and I let my emotions take over. I had an emotional reaction that I regret, and I wish it didn't happen. No one regrets it or is more disappointed than I am.
Now, on yesterday's show, you said 5.
I'm pretty surprised that it's only 3. Mm-hmm. I thought, the one thing I was thinking about today, though, is that he was contrite right after the game. Yep. He's obviously contrite now, so maybe that's factored into it.
Senators forward Bobby Ryan's going to be away from the team indefinitely. He's taking part in the NHL-NHLPA Player Assistance Program. The league and PA made the announcement Wednesday, adding that there would be no further comment. Ryan was not in the Sens lineup Tuesday in Detroit and has been a healthy scratch 4 times this season. He has a goal and 3 assists in 16 games. So we hope everything works out with him.
Yeah, and, you know, his struggles on the ice have been documented. The injury issues, the hands, always. Mm-hmm. It's been a rough go for him. So, yeah, hopefully he's okay. Hey, when we come back, we're whipping it up with Natasha Stanishevsky. That means desserts for Grey Cup weekend. Stay tuned for that. It's time for another edition of Whip It Up Whenever with Natasha Stanishevsky, because, of course, the Grey Cup is this weekend. Or if you're a Leaf fan just sad that Mike Babcock got fired and you need to stuff yourself with sugar, what do you have for us today?
That works too. I wanted to make something Canadian for the Grey Cup, so we're making buttercream filled maple sandwich cookies. Maple is a Canadian thing, right? So we're gonna make little sandwich cookies, not too big, just like the perfect amount of sweetness. So you can have like 3 or 4.
I've never done this segment before.
Look at you, raring to go.
He's got the mixer in his hand.
Okay, so I made like the cookie part this morning, because obviously we can make it here. We're going to make the icing part and fill the cookies. So Dan,
love it. Yep.
You are going to start.
I'll do that. I got it.
By creaming the butter. So I already measured that out. Yeah.
Wait, did you have this in the freezer?
No, I thought I took it out early enough so that it would
melt.
Oh,
no. This is going to be a mess.
Nope. You got to think positive.
Jeez.
Yep. Okay.
And whip that up.
Like, so put that. Yeah. I gave you a nice big bowl, so I was hoping it would not be overly messy. Yeah, I wish I had let that melt a little bit more. Okay, perfect. So that's going to take like a minute or so. Actually, you might be doing that a lot faster than I thought. Okay, so we might just like hang around. Actually, in the meantime, Jay, we need 4 cups of icing sugar. So
I can do that for you.
You can raise the you have it on level 5.
Yeah.
5 out of 5.
I got to measure it off, right?
Yep.
There's one.
Yep. Okay. You're already doing a better job than you did at opening the ice cream at that.
I know.
I am impressed.
Well, we made sure there was no ice cream involved in this particular dessert.
The butter has to melt a little bit. Yep.
It's all stuck in here.
Yeah, okay, here. This is okay. This happens.
What the heck is going on?
And this is the last cup of icing sugar.
You should see my kitchen floor when I make icing.
Perfect.
Actually, it's not that cold. I don't know what the... Okay, it's all right.
Is it real butter?
It is real butter. Yep, buttercream icing. So you need a lot of butter. Okay.
You know what
How
I like?
How much butter was that?
I can't
it
believe it's not
cup.
Butter. Fabio's
All right,
favorite.
Try that again. And I
and
think...
One more. There we
yeah,
go.
And we're going to stop after that.
Okay.
Because it kind of has to come together. Okay, so we need about...
Should there not be a liquid in here?
Yep, look. We're on it. 2 tablespoons of this. So
okay.
I didn't bring my tape. Yeah, there you go. Perfect. Perfect. Okay. Good.
There we go. Now,
and then
you
gotta get that dust down.
Okay. And then obviously we want the maple flavor. So
that's a disaster.
2 tablespoons of that.
2 tablespoons.
Maple flavor. Yes.
Okay.
You can also use real maple syrup, but I think the flavoring makes it a little bit stronger.
Smells good.
Which is nice, right? Right.
Nice
you can smell how good it is.
Yeah. This is gonna be nice.
Okay, I feel like that's coming together better. Okay, Jay, you and I, we're gonna try and pipe this stuff into the sandwich cream.
Perfect.
So,
now, show, I've always been curious about this.
Right.
How do you do that?
I'm gonna show you. Okay, so what you do is you cut off the very small tip of the bag.
Okay.
And then you put, not
just
too far.
Just the tip.
Just the, yep, that's right. Then you take,
bop down
that
again.
One.
Right, put that there. Oh, inside.
I think you need more cream, more cream. Yep, you have to push it through.
How much more?
Tell me
what.
Start with another tablespoon.
Tell me what.
Okay.
No. Yeah, that's about good. Okay, did it go through? Oh, see, okay. We got to cut off a little more.
Oh,
we
got to get more cut
thing.
Off here.
It's hard to estimate, but you don't want to go too far because then there's no going back.
This is very frantic.
I know. This is how it always is on this show. With Tim in our ear, we only have a few minutes left. Okay.
Tim, hurry up. More Babcock news, he's saying.
Okay.
We need
so
more clicks.
So I got one to go. So we have one here.
Okay, one's good.
I'm in the weeds.
Oh, no. I actually don't know.
Okay. There we go. All right, Dan, why don't you give us some of your rich, buttery buttercream?
There we go. It's coming off. I'm going back.
Okay, I think here, let's just add.
Yeah, let's
you
add
know
some
what?
More.
You can never go wrong with more cream.
There you go.
There we go. Okay, easy. Okay, here we go. I'll hold. Yeah, that's good. You have to do that too. We should have put plastic on the whole set down here.
Oh, that's good.
There we go. It's coming along. Yeah, it's good. Okay.
Kay.
Jay,
okay.
Where are
did I'm
you?
I'm right
do
here.
Do you have it?
Good to go. Yeah,
okay.
I got it peeking out.
I think this is the easier one to use. So let's use this one. We're going to go like this.
Okay.
So this.
Oh,
has,
yeah.
Okay, that looks pretty good.
Mm.
Let's see.
Okay.
Well, that that's pretty good.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
That tastes amazing.
Right?
All right.
Okay, so now.
Fill that.
Fill that thing. And the glass just makes it easier. It's supposed to make it easier.
It makes sense.
To fill,
it's
yeah, I should, yeah, you kind of have to, there you go, yep.
But we're going to get a little bit more.
Where's that here? Next, 2 minutes.
Tim says 2 minutes.
2 minutes, okay.
Yeah, really.
Okay, how about one more?
Let's do it.
Okay, and we're going to.
All those days
we
at the gym,
have the emergency icing, which I think we need, so perhaps somebody can bring
Danny,
that to us.
Danny, emergency icing.
And we need our special.
Actually, this might work.
Okay,
we
but,
can get it all the way
right,
up to
I think we got it.
There
okay.
we go.
Okay. Well, then we'll do yours too, because you each need one. So, Jay, now do you know how to pipe?
I guess. Kay. Just squeeze?
Sure. Let's see what happens.
By the way, Natasha, you are not going to the Grey Cup, even though your favorite artist of all time, Keith Urban,
I
is performing.
No, don't remind me.
I mean, it's as if, it's too bad that this network is broadcasting the game and couldn't fly you out to see Keith Urban.
Well, I mean, we should all be going, right?
Yeah, we're fine to stay. Someone's got to run the shop.
That's not bad.
Okay.
Try to go, like, in a circle so it, like, fills in all the...
Yeah. Okay. I'm squeezing. This reminds me of the squeeze cheese. But better.
Right.
Okay.
Okay.
There you go.
And
then squish down.
Sorry, I was mesmerized there for a second at looking at your icing technique. Yeah, and then you just make little sandwiches. So
I love it.
Like this. Pop it on.
Actually, it's very tasty.
Right? Can't you smell the maple?
Yeah.
Can we get that lovely plate up here, perhaps, so we can put them...
Oh.
Can we try them?
Oh,
right. Yeah, it's right there.
Yeah.
I'll get it.
Oh, Dan's got it.
Here.
Actually, this turned out to be pretty good.
That icing actually, that actually worked out. There we go.
There we go.
Yeah, so you guys, yours look pretty good. Are you already eating it?
Oh, was I not supposed to?
There was supposed to be an official...
Well,
official...
we're supposed to taste officially at the end.
All right.
Mmm, these are really good.
Cheers.
The cookies are good.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.
That's well, Natasha.
Once again, this has been Whip It Up Whenever with Natasha Stanishevsky, coming soon to Crave.
Mmm.
Yum.
Still to come.
Look at this.
Should have a helmet on that snowmobile.
Yeah, that's true. That's on producer Tim for sure. Beck Malenstein, Delta BC native, Caps fifth rounder in 2016, former Calgary Hitman, former Swift Current Bronco, robbed by Henrik Lundqvist in his first NHL game, Beck Malenstein.
Luke Monk drives baseline. Love this court. Looks like it's part of your dream. Just like that sweet reverse lay-in is.
Wow, that's nice. I think I already blew it. I think it's Malenstein. Hopefully there's some... it is Malenstein. Sorry. Sorry, Beck. Jason Tatum. Call for the offensive foul on Patrick Beverley. The flop by Beverley. Beverley is one of my favorite players. Just classic. Agitator.
Rudy Gay drives baseline, drives the lane, throws down the monster. One-hander.
Sends and Habs in overtime, Brady Tkachuk, leading Ottawa to its sixth win in eight games. Overtime victory over Montreal last night. How about those Sens?
Everyone's put on lip balm before. I don't think Utah head coach Quinn Snyder ever has.
Wow, that is intense. I can't wait till we get our top 10 balm applications on tomorrow's edition of SportsCenter with Jay and Dan. Look at those two hairs hanging down, too.
And he's got someone on balm patrol.
You might say the bomb squad. Kawhi dunked? All right.
Jay and Dan podcast. We recap our tour across Western Canada with stops in your favorite towns across the land. Listen.
It's the worst play of the day. Patrick Beverley tries to send a pass to Mo Harkless. He's not looking.
Was waiting for Beverley to put up the three.
He is not looking.
Eighth turnover.
Great look.
That's producer Tim's reaction to anything we ask him.
In the corner.
The show. Highlight of the night. Kawhi. Yep.
Why dunk?
Kawhi.
That was a really fun show, but we messed up a few times. Before the Raptors highlights, you called the Raptors Arena the Scotiabank Center. It's the Scotiabank Arena.
Oh.
And then you really struggled with that mixer during the Whip It Up segment.
No, I blame cold butter.
And then you said Dominic Hasek was at a Sabres game Tuesday. It was a Wings-Sens game.
Yeah.
And I messed up. I kept struggling with Beck Malenstein's name during the Jannies. Right hound dog Malenstein. Former Calgary Hitman, Swift Current Bronco, played his first game last night in the NHL.
Okay, so we can be better.
All right, we'll improve.
That's a lesson in life. Always try to be better the next day.
That's right. That's what we try to do each and every day.
Although we won't
Doesn't succeed.
Because the next show is our last show of the week.
And we will mail that show in.
Yeah.
So we hope you join us for that.
See ya.
Yeah!